Hello everybody, today we are going to see type 3, that is construction of triangle. In that, type number 3, that is construction of a triangle of given perimeter and two base angles. Okay, when perimeter of triangle is given and two base angles are given, that time how to construct that triangle, that we are going to see. Before this we have seen when one base angle is given, length of base is given and sum of other two sides is given, that time how to construct that triangle, that we have seen. Then second type we have seen construction of triangle when base is given, base angle is given and difference between two sides are given. In that again we have seen two types. Okay, so now this is the third type of construction, that is when perimeter is given, perimeter is given and two base angles are given, that time how to construct that triangle, that we are going to see today. Okay, with the help of one example we will see. Okay, so example is written on the blackboard. So see here, construct a triangle PQR whose perimeter is equal to 14 cm, perimeter is equals to 14 cm, angle P is equals to 45 degree and angle Q is equal to 60 degree. Okay, such that is this triangle, with the help of this given information we have to construct a triangle. Okay, if you will see its rough sketch or rough figure, then see here perimeter is equal to 14 cm, means triangle PQR, triangle PQR, sum of PQ plus QR plus PR will be 14 cm, because perimeter is given 14 cm. Angle P is equal to, suppose we will take base angle this P, Q and R, angle P is equals to 45 degree and angle Q is equals to 60 degree, and sum of these three sides is 14 cm. So these things are given, two base angles are given and perimeter is given. Okay, we don't know exactly what is the length of this base or what is any length of any other two sides. Okay, that is not given, only perimeter is given. Okay, so this construction also possible, so that we are going to start now. So see here carefully everybody, same thing here we will. Okay, see here, according to the given thing, we are going to take 14 cm, perimeter equal to 14 cm. So that perimeter I am taking here, perimeter is 14 cm, so that I am taking here. So this is, we are going to take here, this is x and this is y. Okay, I have taken little more distance, more length of this for 14 cm, very short length, so I have taken here little more distance. Okay, but you have to take exactly 14 cm. Okay, now what is given, see, angle P is given 45 degree and angle Q is given 60 degree. Okay, so here x and y, xy is the base. Okay, so here at the place of x we will construct 45 degree and at the place of y, okay, we will take 60 degree angle. Okay, so now according to that, this is, I am taking here 45 degree with a convenient radius. Okay, now 60 degree from this point you will get 120 degree. Now we need to take, we need 90 degree we will construct, and then 45 degree. Okay, so now here more than half distance I have taken, mark here, from this mark here join that, then you will get here 90 degree angle. Okay, 90 degree, exactly we need 45 degree. Okay, if you want directly you can use protractor also here. So now we need here, we need 45 degree, so I am bisecting. Now we can do this, see, more than the same distance we can use. Okay, so now here from this point and again here. Okay, so here you will get 45 degree angle. So now I am taking that, okay, now this angle is 60 degree according to the given thing. This is second angle is 60 degree, so 60 degree is very easy. So we need to make a semicircle from this with the same radius, you will make one mark, when you will join you will get 60 degree angle. Okay, so now that I am doing here, okay, so this angle is 60 degree and this angle is 45 degree. Okay, so now here, now again required angles we have now 45 degree and 60 degree. Now we have to bisect again this. Okay, and bisector of 45 degree and bisector of 60 degree will meet somewhere, okay, at a certain point. That point is our point R. Okay, so now again the same procedure we need to do. So here I have taken the same okay, from this point also we can do. Okay, now join that. Sixty degree also bisected. Okay, bisected. Now this is our 45 degree is bisected. Okay, so now it will be 22.5. Okay, and this is 30 degree bisected, and both the bisectors meet at a certain point. That point is R. Okay, now last step we need to do. This is XR and this is RY. Okay, both the bisectors again we have to bisect. Both the bisectors again we have to bisect. Okay, so now this XR we are going to bisect, so take more than half distance with the help of same radius. Okay, bisectors, join that. Okay, so now see here, this is R point and here one intersection point we got. Okay, same thing here, we have to RY, we have to bisect RY, we need to bisect. So take more than half distance here also, the same procedure of bisection of a line segment. So more than half distance, make arc here, from this point make arc here and here join it. So this both the bisectors of line segment RY, bisector of RY and bisector of RX, okay, are meeting to the base. Okay, so this point is our P, this point is P, and this point where intersected, this point is Q. Understood? Now join them. Now join RP and RQ. Joint RP and RQ. Okay, so this is our required triangle PQR. This is our required triangle, this triangle. Understood? So what we have done, see, first initially we have taken XY with the as same as perimeter 14 cm, here 14 cm we have taken. Okay, so 14 cm perimeter is given, so we have to take base 14, whatever given perimeter as same as, then base angles are given 45 degree. So here at the place of X we have taken 45 degree, here at the place of Y we have taken 60 degree. Okay, then again we have to bisect 45 degree and 60 degree. Bisectors of both the angles will meet at a certain point. That point is known as R. Okay, that is vertex point. Now this XR, this line segment we need to bisect, so that bisector will intersect to the base. Okay, same here also we have to bisect RY, that bisector will intersect to the base. Okay, so that is that, this point is P and this point is Q, and finally joined PQR, and this is our required triangle. If you measure the length of PR plus RQ plus PQ will be definitely 14 centimeter. Understood, everybody? Okay, so now suppose you want to prove it, then what is here? This PX is equals to PR because this is bisector. This is bisector and P is on the bisector. So PR and PR and XP are same. Understood? So definitely this is a part of 14 centimeter. Okay, and this is also a part of 14 centimeters. So that part and this part is equal. This part and this part is equal. So tip total is 14 centimeters. So that way we have to write, we can write justification. Okay, so justification you will write in the notebook. Understood? Steps of constructions also you have to do. Just I have shown you today construction. Understood? So steps of constructions you can write by your own. Whatever we have done, that we need to write. Understood? And justification also we can give easily. Okay, thank you.